Hey guys, so in this video we are making a Spider-Man Homecoming web shooter. So this web shooter is really easy to make.
And if you're going to make this, please use this material, which is a spring, because this is part of the shooting mechanism, which will help the web shooter shoot. So the spring will be in the link in the description box below. So I'll leave a link of the springs. So now let's just jump into it.
So first off, I'm going to build the base. So what I'm going to be doing with the base, so I just simply score the cardboard on the back. So I've already did one side, so I'm going to show you how you can do it on the other side. So what you do first is draw a line. And then after you draw a line, you want to simply take your ruler, as you see right here, then just score the cardboard, like I'm doing. And that will get you with a neat fold. Okay, so I just folded the two sides, that way it could fit around my arm better. And then I took these two pieces, and then I folded the two pieces like this. Then I just glued them onto the web shooter. So now is a good time to paint this whole thing black, as you see me doing right here. Next up, I need to work on the animal shooting mechanism, which is creating the barrel. So once you have created the barrel, you need to do a test fit to see if your spring works. So make sure you don't roll up the barrel too tight, so you don't want too much friction. You want the barrel to slide in and out easily. So here is the barrel after I just glued it shut. So I have just cut it out this tiny ring. You see right here. So I'm just gluing that ring onto the web shooter. As you see me doing right here. So I'll be right back once I finish gluing it on. Okay, so I just drenched that ring in super glue so it can be hardened and doesn't rip over time. Now I am making the bullet of the web shooter. So that for that, you just wrapping a strip of paper around a bamboo stick so that way I can fit the spring onto the bullet. So I'll be right back once I do it. And also I glued on a second strip of paper to glue the spring onto the bullet. Okay, so now after you made the bullet, you can slide your spring onto the bullet. And also you can add a little bit of crazy glue to make the bullet not come off. Okay, if you've done everything correctly, your two pieces should work, move together, and the spring should be able to compress like this. So before we glue the barrel to the web shooter, we have to make this nozzle looking piece. So I just cut my web string, so now I'm going to glue it onto the back of my bullet. So I'm going to glue this barrel to sort of nozzle looking piece. See right here. So I have to make sure I glue the barrel on really tightly. You'll see what I mean soon after I glue it on. So here's why I have to glue the barrel on. So the reason why I have to glue the barrel on really tight is that when I load it into the bullet, not to use some force it to it, and from there you end up like gluing the paint job. So you want to make sure your web shooter doesn't like fall on the barrel and not go fall.
This piece right here is what's going to hold the web cartridge.
So now I'm going to be making the trigger
piece for the whole web shooter.
So the way I'm going to make this trigger is pretty easy. So I'm going to take two pieces of cardboard and popsicle sticks, and I'm just going to hot glue the two pieces on top of each other, and then I'm going to make a little gap in between the two pieces, and I'm going to add some duct tape between them. So I'll be right back once I add duct tape between these two pieces. Okay, so I just added the duct tape on the trigger pieces, and that gap in between the two pieces, which is where the two pieces are going to flex down in between each other. So I just made this little popsicle stick, so now I'm going to glue it on the trigger. So I just glued the popsicle stick inside the trigger, so now we can glue on a circle onto the trigger. Okay, so I just made a little circle for the trigger, so I'm going to glue this circle onto the trigger. So guys, the last thing you have to do for this web shooter is make a simple web cartridge that will store all of your string before you shoot it. So here, I'm just painting this whole thing. So this web cartridge is two colors. It's red and silver. So the way I'm going to put this in the web shooter, the way I'm going to attach it on, is I'm going to use some Velcro. That's what I'm going to use to wear the web shooter. So I'll be right back once I finish painting it. So I let the web cartridge dry for a little bit. So now I'm going to be getting ready to reload. So now I'm going to show you how you can reload. So first off, you have to take your body and your web cartridge and also your string and a popsicle stick, and also you need a paintbrush. So what I'm going to do first for the reload is wrap the string around the toothpick, as you see me doing right here. After you do that, you can put the web string into the web shooter, so I'll be right back once I do that. So once you finish loading the string, you can wrap the string around the paintbrush like this. Okay, so after you finish loading your string, you can easily slide that string into the web cartridge, and then you can load the web cartridge up. I'll be right back as I finish playing in the string. Okay, so I just loaded the web string in, as you can see right there. So now we are all done. So if you enjoyed this video, please like, subscribe, and comment, and hit the bell button. I'll see you in the next video. Bye. So now I made this other paper tube, and this tube gets glued on right here. Hey guys, so today I'm making this Spider-Man Homecoming homemade seed web shooter that I made mostly out of cardboard and miscellaneous junk like that. And in this video, I'm showing you the entire process of how to make this whole thing. And if you want to make this as well, there's going to be a free list of materials and a free template in the description box below. Here's what the template should look like once you print it out. So here's what the template should look like. Okay, so guys, when I found this template on Google Images, this looks like a template from Sean's Crafts. So I recommend you guys don't go on Google and find this template. So use the link in the description box below to the template. So first off, I'm making the barrel. So to make the barrel, I rolled up a thin strip of paper into a tube, and then I made this little ring right here. So what I'm doing now is gluing that ring onto the barrel, like this. And then I secured that ring shut with some hot glue. So now I made this other paper tube, and this tube gets glued on right here. So now I'm going to set that piece over the driver mount. So now I'm making that curved metal piece. To start, I took a piece of cardboard, and then I just cutting out the template. Now what I'm doing is just spraying some white glue onto the template right here. So now I'm just gluing that piece on like this. So now I'm going to wait for this piece to dry. So while the template dries, what I'm going to do now is just paint the barrel. So I'm going to paint the barrel silver. So here's what it should look like after you finish painting it silver. So here it is once it dried. So I can set that piece aside for now and go to that later. So now this piece has dried. Okay, so what I'm basically gonna do is just line up my ruler, then just cut the piece out of the cardboard like this. So here it is once I finish cleaning this piece out. So once I finish cutting this piece out, what I can do next is just fold this piece until it becomes a curved piece. So the piece should be curved like this piece right here. So guys, now it could be like a good time to paint this piece after you finish folding it into this curved shape. So here is what it should look like after you finish painting it silver. So now I'm going to work on that red piece. So to start, I'm using some red craft foam right here. So basically what I'm going to do is just cut this little rectangle out of the craft foam so it can fit around my arm well. So here's what the strap piece will look like. So since this craft foam is sticky back, I'm just gonna peel that paper off and then just stick it onto a piece of cardboard right here. So I have to lay it down flat. Like this. So once you do that, you can go ahead and cut off that excess cardboard that's hanging off the edge of the craft foam. So here it is, after I finish cutting off all that excess cardboard. So now I'm going to, this piece is flip it over, and I'm just going to score the cardboard on the back of the wrist piece. Okay, so now that I scored the back, now it's going to be easier to like fold the cardboard like this. So now what I'm doing is I'm going to hot glue these two sides shut like this. So basically I'm just adding some hot glue on the edge. I'm just going to basically stick it shut like this until it becomes stuck. Something like this. Okay, so guys, after you hot glue, after I hot glue, there's this little bit of a seam right here where you can see hot glue. So what I'm going to do is just
I'm gonna paint the seam so you can't see the hot glue very well. And so this is what you do. Just take some red paint, then just paint it on. So here is what it should look like after you finish painting it. Okay, so the craft one seems a little bit pink in my opinion, so I'm just gonna paint that red.
And hey, if you're getting value in this video, please make sure to hit that like button so this video can show off to more people.
So now I'm setting this piece aside and coming back to it later. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is just glue this piece on to the right here. So what I'm doing now is taking a strip of duct tape. What I'm going to do is just put that strip of duct tape right here where that curved piece is, because there's like a little black piece on the web here. So guys, now I made this little guy here, so I'm just gluing that piece right here. Okay, so now I'm taking the barrel and just gluing the barrel onto the web here, right there where this guy is. So now I'm going to make the trigger piece. So to make the trigger, you'll need these four pieces right here. So you'll need two pieces that looks like this, and these two circles right here. So first off, I'm taking these two pieces. I'm taking this trigger piece and this big circle piece. So this is going to be the bottom. So what you have to do first is, so what I did was I just added some hot glue onto the big circle piece. Then what I'm going to do next is just glue that piece onto the trigger right here. And then you want to take this piece, and then what you want to do is just glue this piece right here. And then you should have a trigger that looks like this. And this piece right here will get glued right here. And then I just painted this piece right here, so I'll set this piece aside and move on to it later. So guys, now I made four of these web cartridges. So what I'm doing is taking the web cartridge and gluing them one by one onto a web shear using a bit of hot glue. Okay, so we're not quite done with the back yet. I still have down the black thing right here. So here is the two pieces of duct tape I'm going to add on. So here is the duct tape I added on. So guys, now I'm going to glue on the trigger to the web shear. So now I am all finished with the web shear. Okay, so guys, now we are done with the web shooter. Okay, so now I just made two web shooters. Okay, so guys, if you enjoyed the video, please hit the subscribe button and smash that subscribe button and turn on all those bell notifications. And see ya in the next video.